Hey, Sean Jantz here, and I'm doing a quick battle plan for Monday, September 30th. I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500 and the other indices that you can find on NADEX. And I'm going to start here on /ES. And on Sunday nights, what I like to do, I like to take a little time here on the daily time frame. Right, you can see right there, D for daily. And I think what's important going in starting the week, right, Sunday night's a good time to really start understanding what's going on in the big picture of this market. Doing a quick little recap kind of for yourself and kind of seeing where the market has been, because that can help us on where the market is going as well for the coming week, right? And so when we look here at the daily chart, if I turn on just high Kanashi candles, you can see this daily chart is cycling pretty well, right? Because all the market does is cycle. This little move down was ridiculously easy. Nothing's easy. This was ridiculously easy to anticipate. We pretty much knew that exactly that was going to happen. And you can go back and watch the trade plans. I nailed that, right? And so you can see how we just cycled back up here into that all-time high supply. Bears saw value. We just basically went sideways for about a week. Bears finally broke it. And one thing that I had been talking about for over a week as well was I was talking about this huge resistance that we saw here in August, this really huge resistance and supply zone. Obviously, this was actually just a huge range the whole month of August, right? And if you remember me talking about, more than likely, we did see this break, right? We knew someone was going to win this range. Bulls ended up winning the range. And then what I mentioned to you was, hey, price loves to get sucked back to where it used to be resistance and then break out, obviously, or sorry, just not necessarily break out, but then just cycle back to what used to be resistance, where that initial breakout originated from. And sure enough, it did. It went quick. It basically kind of wicked down to about 29.45, because 45 to 40 is where all of that resistance and supply is, and it went to about 29.45. And so it wicked just right down to it, and then clearly, and like what I mentioned, was this can now become support, and it did, right? An almost 30-point pop right off of what used to be resistance, breakout, now target, now support. See how you can kind of learn how all of this stuff works. By understanding where price has been, it can help you on where it's going. It's pretty cool, right? And you can go back and watch all those trade plans if you want. And so now, though, we look at this daily time frame. Okay, especially for the week, right? We're not overbought anymore. We're not oversold. We're pretty much sitting right here at equilibrium. And when you're at equilibrium, I mean, this chart can literally go any direction. We're going to have to the upside. We're going to have that huge magnet 3000. Then we're going to have the all-time high supply at 25 to about 30, right? And we start breaking. We're going to have targets like right around 2900 to 2850. And so these bears definitely have a lot of room to break, especially if we start getting more negative fundamentals, whether that's from impeachment or not, or the China trade talk. There's lots of room for this market to tank, but there's going to be a lot of room, not as much room to tank, but there will be plenty of room for this to continue cycling, possibly even kiss all-time highs again, especially if we start seeing positive China trade talk, right? But good news, my big point on this, we're at equilibrium. We're sitting in, we got structure up above, we got structure down below, so that's a good thing. We move here to the 4-hour chart, which is what I call the bird's eye view, and you can really see that range that I talked about in August a lot clearer here on the 4-hour chart, right? Just an incredible range high, an incredible range low. There's that breakout, right? Cycle up to back up to all-time high, cycle back down into what used to be resistance, can now become target, can now become support. It's pretty cool I was able to do that, but I'm not anything special. It's just trading every single day for 6-7 years. You're able to learn this stuff, and then I can pass on all of this knowledge to you, and you can start understanding how all these markets like to work. It's pretty cool. Same thing with the 4-hour chart. We're pretty much sitting right here at equilibrium, and we just kind of touched on it. There's not much else to say here as far as we're at equilibrium. This has plenty of room to continue cycling up into that 3,000 to all-time high, where I will be looking for possible resistance. The bears have proven that they see value here, and until proven otherwise, until they break, right? I'm going to continue to look for change control there until proven otherwise. We have started to build, obviously, a little bit of demand here, but if we start breaking, we got to be on, you know, we start breaking, obviously, we're going to be entering areas of the charts where price hasn't been in roughly over a month, so you got to be mindful that if we break, definitely break 40, that's kind of the, in my opinion, that's the key level for these bulls to hold, right into what used to be resistance. If the bulls can hold it, right, that, I'd be fine with that. It's a nice little buy trigger. But if they break, it'll be a little bit trickier, at least on the initial break, because there's nothing here. There's nothing right here to base any buy triggers off of. You know, I think 2,900 is obviously the next big kind of big round number magnet that you, I don't think we're going to make it to 2,900 tomorrow. Just trying to let you know that if we break, what could be coming, right? And if we break, we need to be understand that we're not going to have structure here, so that we'll need to make, we'll need to take a day or two to let the chart build price discovery. Moving right along to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart, no more indicators. And what we're doing here is we're just looking for structure. We're looking for the best places to buy, the best places to sell. We're looking for support, resistance, supply, and demand zones. And what I always do is I start exactly where price is, and then I start planning and visualizing. What am I going to do or not do at every single level if this chart continues to go higher? And then what am I going to do or not do at every single level if this chart continues to go lower? So let's first talk about if we go higher. We're already starting to see about a 10-point push here already Sunday night. Okay, our first context level, you can clearly see it. It's right here. Plus 0.5 Friday's POC. Now, generally, typically, yes, a plus 0.5 value area high, that's a decent level for first resistance. My only concern about, and I don't necessarily mean the word concern, more as my only reservation, I guess, of selling here is that when you think about this, you know, they always say sell high, here's our 15-day range, buy low, here's our 15-day low, here's the middle. They don't say sell high, buy low, fiddle in the middle. They don't say that. Right? And so this is, I'm not saying you can't look for resistance there. You just got to be mindful. That's a lower probability level to be selling. So just be mindful of that. I still like to show all of the opportunities and in the nightly trade plan, take what you like, drop what you don't. This is definitely where it's decent context. It's not terrible. Now, there is something that we could be look for. Instead of possibly using this as resistance, if these bears are strong, like they're showing here, and they continue to be strong, there is a possible opportunity for breakout, pullbacks, and then continue grinding this chart higher. And because you can see, we got a huge target up there, roughly from right here up into big round number 3,000, right? So if these bears are strong and they want to cycle and run towards that magnet of plus one 3,000, you would want to wait for breakouts and then find pullbacks. So you could use traditional futures or touch brackets. So break out and then jump to your 1 minute or 5 minute chart. And then you can use roughly, you know, 1-to-1 risk reward ratios on those touch brackets or traditional futures. And then I would use a quarter deviation for first take profit target. And then you can lock and trail for plus one 3,000. Now, as far as first resistance, and I know I talked about that being first, but as far as like my favorite first, I would need to see this cycle and then obviously get into here or even right around that 3,010. So if we cycle up into that supply zone, I would just need to wait and find change control. That's where I'd want to be looking for my sell triggers. Now, if we go lower, we kind of talked about how I mentioned this price dipped. And I guess the number was 46. The price dipped to what used to be August resistance, right? So this level right here is what used to be August resistance. I mentioned how it now can become a target. Bears went there and then they bounced right off of it. So clearly the bulls bounced right off of it. Clearly the bulls see value there. So I'm not against using this for kind of a second double tap as long as there's good change control. But I did mention as well, we start busting through this, I think it could get trickier of where exactly is going to be the, you know, the the low, basically. We're going to be entering monthly lows down here. If we break 46, you can clearly see that this chart is bearish as far in the last 2 weeks. You got a high, lower lows, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower lows, lower lows. And so if we continue to form lower lows, yes, we're going to be nicely oversold. You got a negative one. You can even look for negative 1.5. I'm not saying that you can't look for buy triggers down here. Just be mindful. There's no structure to the left, at least over a month, right? So you need to know that if you're going to be looking for buy triggers with no proven structure to the left, at least on this 15-day chart, it's just a lower probability. The big key, though, we'll likely see a buy trigger somewhere down there. That's with no structure, it makes it harder. Somewhere, you just gotta wait. If you can stay patient for change control, obviously, if we're dumping, volatility is gonna explode to the upside, which means price is going to move faster. So anytime that happens, you wanna be in and out quick on any trades that you make. And when you get green, freaking take it, because it can reverse on you just as fast when volatility and when bears are dumping. There's gonna be a lot of opportunities to get bull pops, 4, 5, 6 points. But if you don't take the green, it can literally, you can get wiped out within minutes because you're getting too greedy. Get the green, bank the green if you're gonna be doing anything without structure to the left. Slash and Q, pretty much like literally the exact same, except, okay, as far as this sucker, obviously I'm not looking for sell triggers there. But if this breaks and holds higher lows, here's kind of our targets. Possible 80% rule. You got a POC cluster, and you can kind of lock and trail for the full VA high plus one. As far as first resistance, you know, this would qualify, but just be mindful that the supply is really kind of here and here. And so this would be kind of mid-tier, mid-level supply. So if you're going to do it, make sure you're seeing good change control and make sure it's quick, because this chart is more oversold than ES. It has lots of room to slingshot somewhere back up into here. So if you're going to sell here, okay, and I get it, plus one VA high, but think about the structure, think about the cycles. And so if you sell here and it continues to go higher on you, hey, that's just a really oversold chart continuing to cycle back up into that supply. So just be mindful of that. If we go lower, I'm not against looking for kind of that, and that would almost be kind of a triple tap if you can count that 1, 2, and then look for change control. But if this sucker breaks, there really is no structure down here. So you can do whatever you want to do. I'd look for buy triggers, be quick and nimble, wait for higher lows. Slash YM probably has some of the best structure, the most compact. You know, even right there is not terrible, but probably my favorite is kind of waiting for at least up into that nice little supply, 27,100 to plus one. You see down in here, the thing about this chart, negative 0.5, this actually has all of the structure is on 26,700. Now, I kind of do want to quickly show you this 4-hour chart so you can kind of see a little bit of a difference, right? This chart has, this was the August resistance and the breakout. This chart has yet to kind of come back to August resistance. So this chart is lagging ES and NQ, so be mindful of that. This chart could be, if there's overall bears in the stock market in general, this chart could really see a number because, you know, stuff like this is self-fulfilling, meaning these bears could literally just hammer this chart. And so I think, you know, I'm not God, right? And so I'm trying to think as far as, you know, this level around here isn't terrible for first buy trigger. And then kind of talking about that negative one. And so obviously if we do go to negative one, we're going to be touching what used to be the resistance can now become support. So that process has already happened on ES and NQ. Let me confirm that real quick. As far as NQ, that process happened, you know, even earlier than ES. But as far as like what used to be resistance in August, that process has still not happened on YM. And so possibly could be quick buy triggers where a lot of these bears dump this to this level right here. And then a lot of these bears can be looking for support. So you could see a possible quick buy trigger off of that negative one. Slash RTY, when you look at the 4-hour chart, it is completely a lot different, right? This 4-hour chart is very compact. And so when we... you know, this has quite a bit of room to cycle higher up into that plus one. Most of the supply on this chart is up there, and I just don't even think we'll make it there tomorrow. But there is a little bit of resistance around plus one. It's not terrible. I'm not looking for resistance at the plus 0.5. As far as to the downside, one thing that you need to be mindful of is 1500 on this chart's a huge magnet. Okay, so there is going to be some support around negative 0.5, but you got to be mindful that if we're seeing bears in the overall market, this sucker could tank to around 1500. And so be mindful of that. You could also possibly use 1500 around that level for some change control buy triggers, right? So I know I went a little deep, but on Sundays it takes longer, 15 minutes, but you got to really understand where we've been, the story of the larger time frames, because it helps us in our shorter time frame day trades. Don't forget that we also have the deviations on the four major Forex pairs, and we have deviations in value range on crude oil. And then this chart here is empty for just anything else you want to trade. We got 9 charts, markets open 23 hours a day. There's always action somewhere. Message me or Ryan Smith if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades and post them in the group and in the chat rooms so you can get feedback from me and from others.